My name's Wade Coffey, and I put the sun to work with RPS solar pumps. You know, water's a precious commodity here in California, and we want to keep it here for irrigation, cattle, recreation, being able to get us to cool down in the summertime. You know, possibilities are endless if you're able to put water in a hole like this. The closest PG&E, or the closest electrical, on-grid electricals, a little over a half mile from this current location. So from there, we looked into potentially running a generator to pump the water out of the hole. With fuel prices the way they are, that just wasn't going to be an option. We had seen some small versions of solar pumps, mainly in agricultural cattle fields, you know, doing very small volumes though, almost matching the same volume as, say, a windmill would put out. So, you know, at that point we're thinking, well, we need way more volume. We don't need 2 gallons a minute. We need to be pulling, you know, upwards of 50 gallons a minute out of the ground to sustain and be able to support the property. I found RPS just kind of poking around online on Google. I saw some of these videos actually that I'm being featured in today. I saw some pumps being used as fountains that were moving quite a bit of water, which really started to spark my interest. The team was great. I spoke with Natalie over there first off, and that was just in the start of it. It was just an idea at that point. You know, we didn't even have a hole drilled. You know, let alone, you know, the whole blueprint for what we wanted to do. Yeah, so you know, we figured that no pond's complete without an island, right? We are gonna make the pond to where it can be swimmable. You know, we want to keep it clean. Hence the reason why we wanted to go with the Air 200 aerator as well. We are looking to develop this area a little bit more. We do a lot of recreation out here with friends, family. We're gonna have a sandy beach over here, spot for the kids to swim, kids to play. We are gonna set up some locations for our family to come and camp out. We may do a couple of cabins here. My wife has some long-term goals of actually putting a small chapel up here and potentially hosting some wedding venues. Like my wife said, this pond was originally, or the reservoir was originally started by her grandfather. And it was a dream of his to have it full. It's been a dream of this whole family to have this thing full. And we were able to make it come true with the help of RPS, you know, with the support of the family and some hard work, you know. I'll tell you what, my 7-year-old son, he never worked so hard in his life on his fall break. Yep, my 7-year-old son and my 67-year-old dad. You know, he ran logistics, and that means driving back and forth in this thing to gather tools or parts or tow a trailer. You know, heck, my son, he was shoveling on the trenches. He was helping me glue conduit all over the place. Yeah, the 5-horsepower system isn't just going to be for filling the reservoir here. We're also going to fill, I have 18,000 gallons worth of water holding, tanked water. That water will be primarily for fire prevention. Additionally, we'll be able to use that for some irrigation and also just keeping animals watered. You know, once we've got our cattle back in here, we've taken a couple of years off from the property with the cattle just due to the lack of water, the lack of grass. But now that we've got the water source here, we'll be able to come back online with our cattle. So the solar array is actually, it's about 900 feet up the hill, up and behind us over this direction. We chose that location because of the amount of exposure. We decided to drill the well up on that portion. So then if we did get enough water into this pond, I can also branch out and send some of this water for irrigation, livestock, or potentially another pond down the road to the back portion of our property. So now that we know that solar pumping is an option for us, we'll be using it far more readily. It always works, as long as the sun's out. California, we've got a lot of sun. With this, the system was one upfront cost. We had to put in the work to do it, but now that it's up and running, there's essentially zero cost in the system. If I was gonna go with gasoline, diesel, or propane powered internal combustion pump, that's a bill every single day. If I was gonna try and get PG&E to extend on-grid power to this location, that would be an astronomical price. Coffee Cattle Company is gonna be a farm-to-fork beef distributor. So we're looking to raise our own cattle here, fully grass-fed, hormone-free. The family that's eating dinner, right? They'll know where their beef came from. They'll know that it's hormone-free. They know that it was sustainably harvested and not just pushed through big factories.